I think tonight we have a band that's just about as legendary as they come, especially here in North Carolina. And a good friend of mine, Trent Wagler with the Steel Wheels, he describes legendary bands as bands that they take the tradition and they, as he says, they mess it up a little bit and they pass it on to the next generation. These guys have been doing that for decades. Please give a big Charlotte welcome to the one and only Red Clay Ramblers.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Dennis.
Hey, ya, folks.
Awful nice. Well, this is such a beautiful space. I guess we better mess it up a little. What do you say?
I think so. We'll sully it with some tunes here.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
Thanks. Thank you. Well, you are a mighty fine-looking bunch of hairpins, that's all I can say. This is a beautiful spot, and we're just delighted to be here. Thanks, Dennis, for giving us such a nice introduction. I hate to follow that beautiful words that you spoke with a silly song, but I think we will anyway.
That's kind of our way.
It is our way. This is sing-along. We don't tell you what to sing or when. We expect you all to be able to figure it out. At least the members of the society should be able to.
I think so.
Aw, gimme a horse, a great big horse, gimme a buckaroo. Let me wahoo,
wahoo, wahoo.
Then gimme a ranch and a big pair of pants, gimme a Stetson too. I'll go wahoo,
wahoo,
wahoo. Give me the wide open spaces. I wanna be there with those frails. I gotta ride the hills and dales. Show me a moon, a prairie moon. Give me a gal that's true. I'll go wahoo,
wahoo, wahoo.
Oh, what did Cleopatra say to Anthony when they met? She hollered wahoo,
wahoo, wahoo.
And what did the roaming Romeo mention to his Juliet? He whispered wahoo,
wahoo, wahoo.
It started way cause, and that's no fib. She wahooed at him for a rib, so lay me to rest out in the west, but making a May West view, and let me
wahoo, wahoo, wahoo.
I ruin the ladies' shoes.
I can wahoo, wahoo, wahoo.
It's just a gift from the prairie.
You shouted when a bad man jigs.
Mighty good for calling pigs.
I never could speak a word of Greek
or your little hee-hoo. I can wahoo,
wahoo, wahoo.
Thank you very kindly. That's about enough excitement for now, though, yeah. I think.
Just take it easy.
I can't hardly stand it.
You got to take it easy, you know. You got to
pace yourself.
You got to pace yourself. Make sure you got plenty of headroom.
All right. Got what we need?
I think so. We're going to do a slow version of Cotton Eye Joe, sort of thoughtful.
Thank you. did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? But the Cotton Eye Joe. Why did you come from? Why did you go? Why did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? Cotton Eye Joe, Cotton Eye Joe. Why did you come from? Why did you go? Why did you come from? Why did you go? Why did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
Thank you very much, folks. We're going to do a song now that's from the perspective point of view of about a 20-year-old boy down in Johnston County, 30, 40 miles south of Raleigh. And it's back just at the beginning of World War II. And he's got a mind to go up to Chapel Hill, where we had a pre-flight school teaching pilots. And he wants to go up there and learn to fly and join the war effort. I was working in tobacco down in Johnston County when I heard about the war, boys, when I heard about the war. They were bombing France and England. Daddy said we were going in. I made my decision for the Army Air Corps. Send me up to pre-flight up in Carolina. Gonna learn to fly the airplanes. I'm gonna tighten my belt and put me in the big game, right up with Ted Williams. Gonna hit a home run for Churchill and Roosevelt. Now my buddy had a biplane, made his living crop dusting. He was giving me lessons on the throttle and the stick. Now he's flying across the channel to positions that are secret. He wrote, said I could help out. Yeah, but I better do it quick. So send me up to pre-flight up in Carolina. Gonna learn to fly the airplanes. I'm gonna tighten my belt and put me in a big game, right up with Ted Williams. Gonna hit a home run for Churchill and Roosevelt.
know the Eiffel Tower and the white cliffs of Dover. I say you ain't seen nothing
till
you seen them from the air. I tell you where I'm going when this is all over. The field in Johnson County, I'll be coming home on a wing and a prayer. So send me up to pre-flight up in Carolina. Gonna learn to fly the airplanes. I'm gonna tighten my belt and put me in the big game, right up with Ted Williams. Gonna hit a home run for Churchill and Roosevelt. Gonna hit a home run for Churchill and Roosevelt.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Bland Simpson.
That's Bland Simpson over there, way down there on the piano, in case you didn't see him over there.
Thank you.
You're going to see quite a bit more of him as the night goes on. We might even make him stand up a time or two. Meanwhile, though, I can't see my list. What's coming up here, boys? Oh, God.
Mr. Chris Frank.
In the Fez.
A sad song, I hope you don't mind.
And this is not to say that they didn't feed him while he was here. Somehow, it didn't stick.
The little man had walked up and down to find an eating place in the town. He read the menu through and through to see what 15 cents would do. One meatball, he could afford but one meatball. It told the waiter standing near at hand about the simple little dinner that he had planned. Guests were startled, one and all, to hear the waiter. He snidely called, he went like this.
One meatball.
That's what I thought he said.
One meatball. Hey, everybody. Big Shot over here is going to have a whole meatball for his dinner tonight. I just hope he can finish it.
The little man, you know, well, he felt so ill at ease. He looks up, he says, some bread, sir, if you please. The waiter, he just hollered back down the hall. He says,
you get no bread with one meatball.
No.
One meatball.
Yeah, I heard that.
One meatball.
Why you keep reminding me? You get no bread, not with one, not with one meatball. Let's play the blues. What do you say? Felt so very, 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 very bad, cause this one little old meatball, it was all that he had. And in his dreams, you know, they still hear the call that says you get no bread, not with one meatball. You just get
one meatball.
One meatball, you just get
one meatball.
Not with one
meatball.
no bread, not with one meatball.
Mr. Chris Frank of Carrboro, North Carolina. Oh, thank you so much. You're very kind. And I might add, very nicely dressed. And it would seem quite well-mannered as well.
So far, so good.
So far, so good. We'll just see how deep you are.
Yes.
I'll start with a few simple questions. Can you name the North Carolina state flower, for instance? That was. It's interesting that the state flower is a tree, is it not? But it's true. That's the way we do things in North Carolina. The state trees, anybody know what the state tree is? Very good. It is the pine, not the longleaf, not the loblolly, not the ponderosa. It is the pine. How about the state dog?
Whoa.
Bang.
Somebody, I think that's a free record to that man.
Somebody was waiting on that one. How about the state pie? You are a cagey bunch. You are indeed. It's true. There is no North Carolina state pie that we know of. That's more of a local thing, you know, town by town. How about the North Carolina toast? What is our toast? Is it French, whole wheat, brioche? Texas? We're going to sing the state toast for you now.
I love French toast.
Here's to the land of the longleaf pine, the summer land where the sun does shine, where the wheat grows strong and the strong grow great. Here's to down home, the old North State. So raise a glass to a land so fair, where friends are true and a cold heart rare. That dear old land, whatever fate, here's to down home, the old North State. Here's to down home, the old North State.
Thank you.
Rob Ladd back there banging on the stick.
Thank you, friends. You're very kind. And like I said before, you are very well-mannered. You're obviously raised right.
I
think they could accept something even a little more sophisticated than what we've so far
I think
far
you might
shown.
Be right. I think we're ready to kick it up a notch.
All right, let's go ahead.
In the smart department here.
All right.
We're going to do something from the legitimate repertoire, okay? So buckle up.
Yeah, really.
This one comes from, this is, as Clay said, this is one of the classical greats. It comes from the ancient pen of Homer and Jethro. Can't forget him. And we hope you survive it.
It's really classy.
In the city, we was wondering where to go. A sign spelled out Pagliacci up in lights above a show. We thought 'twould be a western till the stage lit up with light. Then 97 people sung without a horse in sight. We couldn't understand them 'cause they spoke a foreign tongue. But we can give you some idea of what we think they sung. All at once there's this fat guy in a clown suit. Tain't Halloween, that's for sure. Then this here feller, this Punchineller, begins to beller like we all was deep. That was Pagliacci. Song. Invest in a tuba and something or other about Cuba. He sung about a lady who weighed 280. When she takes a powder, he just starts chirping louder. And he don't do a gall-darn thing except to stand up there and sing. When we listen to Pagliacci, we get itchy and scratchy. This sure is top corn, so we go and buy some popcorn. We hate to go back, but we can't get our dough back. Ain't no use complaining, 'cause outside it's a-raining. Darn theater, taking turns a napping, waiting for something to happen. Pagliacci, he ain't hurrying, but the folks on stage are flurrying, and it sounds like Cacciatorian's saber dance. Then old Pagliacci finds the guy he's seeking, cheek to cheek, and with his wife he grabs a knife and stabs the louse who stole his spouse. Then he stabs the lady and himself. Tain't very sanitary. They all collapse, but old Pagliacci sets up. Then he gets up saying, I'm dying, I am dying, I am dying. We start crying, 'cause to tell the truth, we're dying too. As the footlights fade out, we see Pagliacci laid out, but the dagger never caused it. Pagliacci was plumb exhausted.
Pretty Pagliaccio.
What an audience of such taste.
Yes. Quality really. Entertainment.
Quality entertainment, yes, folks.
Never goes out of style.
It does never go out of style. What are we going to try now after that mess?
Well, I don't know. We could do a nice ballad, or we could do something kind of peppy. We could do either one. We go to our right, or we go to our left. You know what I'm saying?
What do you want to do?
Let's do that ballad.
Do the ballad. Yeah. Right. We're going to get Clay to sing one that's actually a nice song. I mean, after imitating a 400-pound guy in a clown suit, I think we'll let him sing a nice tune.
I'll imitate Louis Jordan instead. This is actually a really cool ballad that comes from Louis Jordan. And if some of you may not be familiar with Louis Jordan, he was one of the masters of jumping jive back in the 40s and 50s and early 60s. And he wrote a lot of great American songs like I Like 'Em Fat Like That, and Chartreuse, and Is You Is or Is You Ain't, My Baby. And those are just some of the obscure titles. And this one is a ballad called It's Hard to Be Good Without You. I took a stroll in the park, got home about 10, jumped into bed, started dreaming again. I try to be good, I know that I should, but it's hard to be good without you. And in each dream I can see that old rendezvous. Somebody else is taking my place with you. I try to be good, you say that I should, but it's hard to be good without you. You better hurry, hurry, baby, hurry. Ease this pain in my heart. You know I worry, worry, baby, worry. Ever since we've been apart, I know someday we'll regret the game that we play. But I'll never forget the vows that we made. I try to be good, I know that I should, but it's hard to be good without you. The game that we play, I'll never forget the vows that we made. I try to be good, I know that I should, but it's hard to be good without you. A stroll in the park, got home about 10, jumped in the bed, started dreaming again. I try to be good, I know that I should, but temptation, frustration, aggravation, ruination, and no love at all. It's hard to be good without you.
Yeah, man. That's Clay Buckner.
Thank you so much.
I think he does a mighty fine job.
Well, I appreciate that, but I think it's probably time to get riled up again.
Okay, we'll get rowdy again. We enjoy doing that. It's a departure from our usual nonsense.
It's
but,
true.
So what are we going to try instead?
I think we're going to go back to our rootsy selves here for a minute. This is a song, this next song is called Way Down Yonder. We wrote it as the opening song of a musical adaptation that we did some years back with the late and very great artist, Doug Marlette, who worked in Charlotte here for many years. And we worked this up with Doug. We were doing a workshop of the show up in Connecticut, and our agent said, you got to help these folks out. They don't know what kudzu is. And so we put a TV show in the lobby with Jim Dickey talking about kudzu. We sang this song. We mentioned it 432 times during the course of the two-hour musical, and people from Connecticut still came out of the theater saying, boy, that kudzu really is something, isn't it? Well, everyone in this room knows how it's pronounced, so with a big salute to our late friend Doug Marlette, here's Way Down Yonder. Yesterday morning when I woke up, I saw a bullfrog sitting on a buttercup. I rubbed my eyes and looked back again. He said, come on over here and meet all my kin.
Way down yonder, yonder, here we go. Way down yonder, yonder, here we go. South of here, but north of the Gulf of Mexico.
Here's a place covered up by a Japanese plant, sent to stop erosion by the government. The kudzu grew and it would not stop. Now we're down in the bottom with the vine on top.
Come on, somewhere been forgotten. We live right in the middle of it, way down yonder.
And we like it a lot.
Way down yonder, yonder, here we go. Way down yonder, yonder, here we go. South of here, but north of the Gulf of Mexico.
Shade of a longleaf pine, I hang my bucket for the turpentine. Roll that barrel to the riverside, sail away on the outbound tide.
Nothing I want that I ain't got. We live right in the middle of it, way down yonder.
And we like it a lot. Anytime the world gives too much push, I go down to the river and the willow bush. Lay there looking at the tall pine trees, bullfrogs singing on the evening breeze.
We've been a long, long time in the very same spot. We live right in the middle of it, way down yonder.
And we like it a lot.
Way down yonder, yonder, here we go. Way down yonder, yonder, here we go.
The Thank you very much.
Thank you, folks. Because he's seated so remotely at the piano, we thought we might get Bland to come up and do something special. And I noticed that everyone else is leaving, so that's my cue. This is my great partner and friend, Mr. Bland Simpson.
Thank you, Jack. Jack knows me very well. We've been friends for most 50 years, and he knows that when we play that last riled-up song, that sometimes I get a notion to tell a story about my second cousin once removed's uncle by marriage. And this is a true story, and that's actually the man's relation to me. His name was John Farabee, Uncle John Farabee. He lived in Dare County down on the North Carolina coast, and he was a county commissioner there on the Board of Commissioners of Dare County in Mateo. And this is back in the 40s and 50s and 60s. And they were going to build the airstrip there right next to the Wright Brothers Memorial. Many of you, I'm sure, have been to that memorial at Kill Devil Hills, right? So, you know, on the west side of the hill down there's an airstrip. They're getting ready to build it. There are a bunch of little houses there, cottages, and the county's going to tear them down. Well, Commissioner Uncle John Farabee says, tear them down. They're perfectly good. And the other commissioner said, well, what would you do with them, John? He said, well, I'd move them. He said, what do you know about house moving? He said, well, nothing yet, but I'm going to learn. So he did learn. And he became the preeminent house mover in that part of the world. And he moved those cottages to start with. And then he moved hundreds of cottages, many of them back from the encroaching ocean. It was easy then because there was no second line of cottages. You just shunted back a little bit. He moved a small hotel down the beach, and any number of it, and over on Roanoke Island, hundreds and hundreds of cottages. And his motto was on the side of his trucks, it said, Farabee and Sons, no job too large or too small. And they even conferred with him back in the 50s when they first started talking about moving the Cape Hatteras Lighthouse back from the ocean. They talked to him at some length. Now, that didn't happen, we all know, till 1999. But the old-timers say that when the expert house movers of Virginia Beach got around to moving it, they used some of Uncle John Farabee's methods. Well, anyway, he was famous as the man who could move anything. Famous in Derrick County and Southern Currituck and Eastern Tyrol and that way. But we do know that at least one time his fame transcended the sound country of Eastern Carolina and made it all the way to New York City, and it happened like this. A little old lady from Mateo decided she wanted to see Manhattan at least once in her life. So she flew up there, and her first morning came down to the lobby of the hotel, and she bought a ticket for the Gray Line tour. The bus is sitting right outside. A half-day tour of historic sites of Manhattan. So she goes out with 30, 35 other people and a tour guide, gets on the bus. Tour guide takes them downtown to the financial district and shows them in the middle of all these towers of commerce. He shows them the old Dutch house, a little two-story job. It's tilting a little bit. And he explains why it's tilting like it is and why the paint is the color it is and why it's flecking off the way it is. And well, a little old lady from Mateo is in the back of the crowd, and she listens to all this. And after he finishes his spiel, she says, we got one of these back home. The tour guide hears her, but he doesn't say anything. He just kind of bites his tongue. They go on over to St. Mark's Place there in 2nd Avenue and 7th, 8th Street in that area, and he shows everybody these beautiful residential buildings and commercial buildings with the Italianate details around the windows and so on, and the roof lines and all that. And well, the lady from Mateo, she just thinks about the commercial buildings downtown there near the water. And when the tour guide finishes his spiel, she says, a little louder this time, we got some of these back home. The tour guide bites his tongue again. They go down to the South Street Seaport, and he shows all the square riggers and the great schooners and dories and everything there. Well, this lady from Mateo just thinks about the juniper skiffs and the spritzel skiffs and everything right down there on Shalabag Bay at the end of the water street. And she says at the end of his spiel, we got some of these back home. And he doesn't say anything. He bites his tongue. And it goes on like this at every single stop, half-day tour, until they get to the final historic site of the day, the Empire State Building. So they go up to the observation deck, and the tour guide's showing everybody the beautiful outlines of the Manhattan skyline and all the yellow cabs zooming around down below. And then he preempts the little old lady from Manhill. He slaps the side of the building, and he says, "Well, madam, I know you don't have one of these back home." And she says, "No, but we got somebody can move it." Say amen, somebody. That's a true story, folks. Absolutely true. Every word.
All right, I believe it. Glenn never lied.
I've heard that one. It's true.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Clay Buckner on the fiddle. You know, I think that one's maybe on one of our long-playing compact discs.
That's right. Oh, I
they're
forgot.
Unavailable, they're not available anywhere.
Nowhere, except right here tonight in
only
this very place.
Tonight.
And over the strenuous objections of our vice president in charge of sales and distribution, Mr. Chris Frank, we're going to offer the Charlotte special.
I hate it when we do this.
I know. He hates it. No. But we haven't been down here in a long time, so I think it's appropriate. We're gonna offer our long-playing, slow-selling CDs at the unheard-of low price of $10 per.
Oh, you're killing me.
No, I know, I'm killing you. And as if that wasn't enough, we're going to go the extra mile, and we'll go 2 for $20. So please see the man after the show. We'd be delighted to sign them for you. And also, I should mention the ironclad Red Clay Rambler CD guarantee, and it goes like this. If you purchase a compact disc from the Red Clay Ramblers and for any reason you don't like it, simply return it to us and we'll send you one that we don't like. So, comes out pretty good.
You better believe it.
Should we do a Nasty Blues? Is that what's up?
Snuffed?
No, that's not blues.
Well, actually, there's apparently a lot of different choices right at the moment.
Oh, is it one of those? We have the kind of set list that it looks kind of like a spider graph. It goes off in three different directions after every song. And well, what's our choice?
Well, I think, it says on here there's a song called Kiss Me Quick.
You want to play that? I'll play that.
It's okay with me. It's kind of an old-fashioned courting song, kind of a little comedy courting song from back in the string band era. We stole this one from the Georgia Yellowhammers, I believe. But they were already probably, you know, too old to really fuss about it too much. We got to do this once in a while.
We tune because we care. This is a song of kind of unsuccessful courting song, and in no right way reflects the happy marital status of the singer, Mr. Clay Buckner.
Heck no. This is called Kiss Me Quick and Go Away. 1, 2, 3.
Other night while we sit spooning, softly whispering in our love crooning, thought the old folks and the children were all in bed. I hear footsteps softly walking, and you bet I then quit talking, as she slipped a little bit closer up and said, Kiss me quick
and go away.
Go away. Then no one
will ever know.
It's too late,
to longer stay.
No longer stay.
Kiss me quick, my honey, oh, kiss me quick and go,
King Fred. Well, I felt the hour cheating and my heart it did quit beating when the old man spied me peeping through the crack. I ought to know whether than I had business around that house I went a-whizzing with the big white English bulldog on my track. Oh, kiss me quick
and go away.
Then no one
will ever know.
It's too late
to longer stay.
Kiss me quick, my honey, oh, kiss me quick and go. Jumping fences, and I like to have lost my senses when that big white English bulldog caught my rear. Up the hill and down the level, I couldn't outrun that big devil with them words ringing softly in my ear. Oh,
kiss me quick
and go away.
Go oh, kiss me quick and go. Kiss me quick, my honey, oh, kiss me quick and go.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much.
That's great.
I love it, passing the hat out there. I feel like we should be singing the doxology right now. I mean...
Should we sing that one?
Which one?
No. What
are
we doing?
I don't know that
Z?
One.
Z?
Yeah.
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 Good idea.
Okay. Okay, we're in a church kind of, so we're going to do a gospel number.
Okay.
All right.
Wait for Kingfish. He's... Come up to the front. Yeah, come up here. Come up here.
Then I'm going to come up there.
Come up there.
Come up somewhere.
Come up. Pretend like we know what we're doing.
Well, Ezekiel was in the valley all the Lord's day. Well, God told Ezekiel to prophesy. Now hear ye the word of the Lord. Ezekiel was in the valley all the Lord's day. Well, God told Ezekiel to prophesy. Now hear ye the word of the Lord. My Lord, he called Ezekiel as the son of man to preach the gospel to the sinful man. People of Israel, it got so wicked, my God stops. He calls Ezekiel saying, hey, Ezekiel, go prophesy. The wicked man is born to die. Ezekiel went down into Israel land to preach the gospel to the sinful man. But the people of Israel would not care. So my God says, the time is near. Gonna make me a city in my own way for a nation of people that will obey. So God, he came in the middle of the night. He destroyed that city with all his might. He put Ezekiel in the valley prophesying, saying, hear ye the word of the Lord. Now the toe and the foot bone join together, and the foot and the ankle bone join together, and the ankle and the leg bone join together, and the leg and the knee bone join together, and the thigh and the hip bone join together, and the thigh and the hip bone join together. Now hear ye the word of the Lord. Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones. Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones. Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones. Now hear ye the word of the Lord. And now Ezekiel, he raised up his head. He found that he was lying among the dead. Well, God said, Ezekiel, can these bones live? Ezekiel said, God, if it is, I will. Then Ezekiel, he began to prophesy. They tell me that the bones began to rise. He prophesied high up to the wind. Blow your breath in the bones that they might live. And then them bones began to walk. Oh, they stood on the ground, began to talk. Ezekiel said, you dry bones, won't you hear ye the word of the Lord? Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones. Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones. Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones. Now hear ye the word of the Lord. Hear ye the word of the Lord.
Thank you very much.
Sorry.
We
sort of do. We're going to do it's another song of romance sung by Clay Buckner. It is a cautionary tale, and I know that a lot of North Carolina commerce is based on the noble tobacco plant. But here's a song that looks at the dark side.
The dark brown side.
All right. I guess there's nothing left for us but to sing it.
You'll probably understand the title of this tune in a very short time.
Snuff dipping woman, snuff dipping woman, snuff dipping woman can't be mine.
Now here comes Mabel walking down the street, looking so fine, awful sweet, and I would ask her right now to be my wife, but she has got a bad habit, and that ain't right, because she likes to dip snuff. She never get enough. She likes to dip snuff. Snuff dipper, snuff dipping woman can't be mine. Now you don't have to be nice to be my wife. You can spend all my money and stay out nights.
Yeah.
You can smoke cigarettes. You can puff cigars. And you can sip your favorite wine in your favorite bars. But there is one little thing you need to know. Because if you got to dip snuff, baby, you just got to go. Yes, you like to dip snuff.
Snuff dipper.
You never get enough.
Snuff dipper.
You like to dip snuff.
Snuff dipper, snuff dipping woman can't be mine.
Kiss you, your mouth is full of snuff. It's such a nasty habit, baby. How can you stomach this stuff? And there you stand with the snuff in your mouth. And you'd be such a nice looking woman if you would just take it out. Yes, you like to dip snuff.
Snuff dipper.
You never get enough.
Snuff dipper.
You like to dip snuff.
Snuff dipper. Snuff dipping woman. Be mine.
Feel so ashamed, but I know it's not you, baby. It's that snuff is to blame.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, you like to dip snuff.
Snuff dipper.
You never get enough.
Snuff dipper.
You like to dip snuff.
Snuff dipper. Snuff dipping woman can't be mine. Snuff dipping woman. Snuff dipping woman.
One little star shining will light the way to it, no matter how far the road goes. It'll lead you back to us. You'll never be too far from home. And home, home, shining in the rearview mirror. Do you think it's getting closer? That's just the way that it appears. Home, we're here no matter where you roam. You'd never be too far from home. And home is a place locked up in every heart. And it will always be the same. Though the ones you love are far apart, home is where they will remain. Though you go down every highway, you'll never be a stranger. Your heart will always have a home, home. Here, no matter where you roam, you'll never be too far from home. You'll never be too far. You'll never be too far. You'll never be too far. Satan says that I will never be traveling that highway home. But when I am ascended, he will have to flee traveling that highway home.
I'm traveling that highway home. I'm traveling that highway home. So narrow the way, thank God I can say I'm traveling that highway.
Buy me a big Oldsmobile, I'll be traveling that highway home.
I don't doubt.
Yes, that's right. Red bucket seats and a gold steering wheel. Traveling that highway home.
I'm traveling that highway home. I'm traveling that highway home. So narrow the way, thank God I can say I'm traveling that highway home.
Travel safe.
Thank you, folks. You're very kind.
Thank you, guys.
It turns out that we do know one more tune that we'd like to do for you. We'll play you some polkas.
You may dance.
You may dance if you wish. These are dancing polkas.
How do they start anyway?
Yeah, right.
Thank you very much, folks. It's great to be back in Charlotte. Thank you.